Hello everyone. In the previous class, we have discussed about the spaces. So we have discussed about the column space, matrix space, or function space. In the today's class, the examples following the definition of a vector space, we expressed the intuition that some spaces are the same as the other, and in this way we are going to introduce two different definitions. One definition when two spaces are exactly the same, and another definition when two spaces are not exactly same but they are alike. So let us start the class. So I am going to start with one motivational example. Motivational example. And actually this example is based on the column space. So it means that vector is in form of column. So let us write the space of two wide row vectors and the space of two tall column vectors. So basically we are talking about these two vectors. So first I am going to talk about the two wide row vectors. So I am assuming situation like this. Suppose my situation like this, any generalized element you can take. So I am taking a0, a1, and after that, so here a0 and a1 may be any real number, and I am talking about the space, another space. So this is our first space, and suppose I have another space like this, that is the second space. So this space as well as this space are the same, and whenever we are talking something is same, then we have to specify the property in that if we associate the vectors that have the same component. So basically what I am telling that I have a space where each element can be represented in form of a0 and a1, and this is a, one can also interpret this as a row vector and this as a column vector, or one can represent this as a two column or this as a two row, something like this. So where a space is filled with first kind of vector and a space is filled with the second kind of vectors, so I have two different spaces basically. So I am talking about these two different spaces, and after that we are telling that these two spaces are same. So these two spaces are same means we are talking about the correspondence between these two spaces. So So, and during this correspondence, we are assuming that here first element A0 in this space is exactly same to this to the first element in the second space, and similarly A1 is same as the second element of the another space. So in order to talk about the property, we are telling that these two space is the same, we have to talk about first the correspondence, means somehow I am talking about the 1 1 and on 2, and after that we are talking about the operations. So in order to define the vector space, we have seen that we are extensively talking about the vector addition and scalar multiplication. So again we are going to see these two operations with respect to this mapping, means mapping between first space to the second space. So I am telling that stated generally under the correspondence and that correspondence I have already talking about. So this is this symbol for the correspondence between these two spaces. We are telling left hand side implies right hand side and right hand side implies the left hand side. And I am talking about those two operations. So both operations are reserved. So let us check about the addition first. So A0 and A1, I am assuming A0 and A1 as are the real numbers. So that is equal to A0 plus B0. So I am doing component wise summation, A1 plus B1. So this operation I have done in first space. So in second space I have basically doing this B0 B1, and that is A0 plus B0 and A1 plus B1. So if I have selected two element from the first space, and if I apply the addition operation, and if I select again same two element from the second space, and if I perform the addition operation, then whatever results, so first element after operation in the first space is exactly same on the second space, that is A0 B0, and similar about the second element. After that I have to check second operation. So this is about the scalar multiplication. So I am performing this operation in first space, and this is correspondence to R A0 A1. So basically now I am in second space. So in first space, if I scale the first component by R, so similar kind of scaling is also applicable in the second space. That is the meaning of preservation of the scalar multiplication. So you can see that I have two different space. In first space, I am talking about the row vectors, and in second space, I am talking about the column vectors, and both space are basically the same or same way if I apply vector addition, you can tell, or just addition, then similar kind of things are going to reflect in the second space. Due to that reason, we are telling that these two spaces are the same. Let us try to see another example. So basically we are just going to define what is meaning of the same whenever we are talking about the two different space. So second example is little more involved. So another two spaces that we can think of as the same are P2, and here P2 I have defined the space of quadratic polynomial. So this is our first space. So another two space that we can think of as the same are the first space, that is the space of quadratic polynomials, and R3, where I have some column vector which has three element, and in order to talk about the same, I have to define again the correspondence. So correspondence, somehow I am talking about the function. So a natural correspondence is this. So first you can specify the first space, so a1x plus a2x. So the space of quadratic polynomial, this is the generalized one, so a0, a1 and a2 are any real number, and I have here 1x and x square. So due to that reason, we are telling this as a quadratic polynomial. and I am talking about this space. So A0, A1 and A2. So I have just collected the coefficient of this polynomial, and after that I am going to put that inside the three dimensional space. This is R3, so this side is P2, and this is nothing but R3. So now I am going to see that whatever structure I have taken, so this preserve structure corresponding elements add in a corresponding way. So if I apply the addition operation here, then in the alike space similar kind of modification comes into picture. So somehow I am talking about that. So let us see the first operation, that is addition. So basically I have a0 a1x plus a2x square, and second element from the same space from the quadratic polynomial can be represented like this. So if I talk about the addition, so basically I have a0 b0. We already know how to add the polynomial. So this is the addition b2 x square, and I am talking about this. If I see the second space, then in second space I am going to collect the coefficient from the first one, similarly the coefficient from the second one, and after operation I am going to see this one. So if I do operation in first space, similar kind of operation also comes into picture in this second space, and a scalar multiplication corresponds also. So basically I have R is the sum scalar, and if I will take any element from the first space, means from the quadratic polynomial, so I will get this form after the scaling, and if I apply the similar scaling in the second space, then I will get these coefficient, and one can easily see that this coefficient R A0, R A1, R A2 are the coefficient of this quadratic polynomial. So using these two examples, what we have observed that if I have two different space, so in first place I have talking about the space, first space where I have some kind of row vector, and in second space I have column vector, and entry are the same, then we are telling that both space are exactly the same because I have some kind of correspondence and they preserve the two operations, and that two operations are addition and scalar multiplication. Similarly, I have talked about the one space, that is a space of quadratic polynomial, means that is function space, and after that first second space is column space, so here I have vector in form of column and that I have represented in R3, and we have seen that again similar kind of property like first example is also going to hold here. So now you can see that this kind of things may be generalized for large class of spaces. So due to that reason, definition comes into picture. So our next definition, and I'm going to coin the some name that is called isomorphism. So and isomorphism between two vector spaces. So suppose I have vector space V and W is a map, and somehow I am going to talk about the function that so I am going to write the two properties is a correspondence. So basically we are talking about the correspondence, means F is one to one and on to, and after that I have second property that is same like preserves the structure. So after application of the mapping F on the vector space V, whatever vector space comes into picture, that is going to preserve the structure, means addition as well as scalar multiplication. So if V1 and V2 that belongs to V, then we are telling that after applying this kind of rule, so if I add any two element of the space V and if I apply this map, then we will get this structure, and FV2. So this is about the first structure, and beyond this I also hope this, if V belongs to V and R is the scalar, then, or you can in general form, you are one can think that R is the element of the field, then I can write like this, R V equal to R dot F. So this is just about the scalar multiplication, and we are going to write V is isomorphic to W. So you can read like this, V is isomorphic to W, when such a map exists and if you see the name, then name will imply everything. That we are talking about the isomorphism. So basically name here they have put in very good way. So that is, we are talking about the morphism. And if you check the meaning of morphism, then it means map. So isomorphism means a map maps expressing sameness. So basically we are telling that if there exists some kind of map like F which will satisfy these two properties. So first property is related to the correspondence, means 1-1 and on 2, and after that second property is the preservance of the structure, means a scalar multiplication and the vector addition. These kind of property, if that will preserve, then we can tell that two space are exactly the same with respect to that particular map. So space V and W are also isomorphic with respect to one another. So V is isomorphic to W, or W is isomorphic to V. And in order to show that things, we are going to use this kind of equivalence notion. So, and I have already written that we write V is isomorphic to the W. And if you see the engineering systems, so basically if you remember in the first part of our lecture, at that time most of time we are interpreting system like this. So basically I have certain kind of object inside this block, so And what is property of this block? That if I apply something here, then we are getting something here. So basically here I have input and here I have output, and this particular block is acts like some kind of function. So you can think about some kind of map here, f. So now I have two different space. One space is the input space, and after that another space is the output space. For example, if you just keep here resistor, and after that if you apply some current as a input, then you are going to get the voltage as the output. Now we are going to see the space. So we are going to talk about the space on the input side and space on the output side. So they may be same or may not be same. If they are same, then we are going to tell that input space is isomorphic to the output space. And how to check this? So you have to check only two property. First property, you have to check about the correspondence, and second property, you have to check about the preservance of the structure. So that is the rough idea. So let us see some kind of the examples, other examples, and using examples one can easily understand the concept. So examples, so two examples we have already seen, that is that are the motivational example. Another example, the vector space and I am denoting element of each vector like this, c1 cos theta plus c2 sin theta, where c1 and c2 are the real number of functions of theta is isomorphic to R2, and whenever we are talking about isomorphism, at that time I have to define the map. So map for this is like this, c1 cos theta plus c2 sin theta, and in order to denote the map we are using this kind of symbol, and here f, c1, c2. So here you can see that I have some space g. So this is the functional space or a space of a function, or this is basically I have a space that is R2. So this is our column space, and we are telling that these two space, so this is the space G. So G is the space of a function and R2 is the column space, and we are going to prove that these two space are exactly the same. So in order to establish this property, so to establish that f is 1 to 1. First we have to prove that we must prove that FA equal to FB only when A equal to B, and during your preparation or during your 10 plus 2 you have already seen about this, that when one can talk about the 1 to 1 function or onto function. So this is the way to prove that some function is 1 1. So let us see that whatever function I have written, that is 1 1 or not. So if I am telling that a1 cos theta plus a2 sin theta, that is exactly equal to f b1 cos theta plus b2 sin theta. So basically I have taken two different element from the first space or space G. So this basically, this particular element, this belongs to G, and this particular element also belongs to G. And after that I will apply these two map, and first I am assuming that these two map are equal. So then by the definition of correspondence I can write like this: a1 a2. So now I am going to talk about the isomorphic space. So in isomorphic space, if I have function like a1 cos theta plus a2 sin theta, then that is isomorphic to the R2. So I have to just collect the coefficient of this particular function, and similar kind of things I have to do for the second space. So basically now I have to just show that these two things fold. So from here, so from which we conclude that if two column vectors are equal, then we know that exactly each and every column, each and every element of the column are equal. So I have a2 equal to b2. So, and this, because column vectors are equal only when they have equal components, and from here I can conclude thus a1 cos theta plus a2 sin theta equal to b1 cos theta plus b2 sin theta, and as required we have verified FA equal to FB and this implies that A equal to B. So in this way I can prove where A is the column vector which has component A1 and B1, A1 and A2, and B is the column vector which has component B1 and B2. Now I have to prove the onto also. So second proof we have to do that to prove that F is onto. Again we have to check that any number of the codomain, and I hope that you are already aware about the domain and codomain of the function. So R2, since we are mapping from space G to F, is the image of some member of the domain G. So let us consider a member of codomain. So member of the codomain of this form, because this belongs to R2, and I can, by seeing the member in codomain, I can write from the function that, and note that it is the image under F of x cos theta plus y sin theta. So from the image of, from the element of the codomain in G, I can easily guess the domain, and form, if I fix the form of codomain, then I can easily guess the form of element in the domain. So, and we know the form of element in domain is of this form, that is x cos theta plus y sin theta. Due to that reason, we are telling that this map F will satisfy the property of onto also. So now next thing I have to verify, that is about the structure. So next we will verify the structure, means condition 2, that f reserve structure with respect to addition and multiplication I have to check. And now I am going to do computation, and using that computation I am going to show that this will preserve the structure. So this computation shows that f preserve addition. So take two element from the space G, and after that you can apply the map. So f a1 cos theta plus a2 sin theta, and after that I am going to take any another element from the same space. So I can write the form of element, and after that I am going to apply this function f. So you can see here that I can also write like this: a1 b1 cos theta plus a2 plus b2 sin theta, and after that from the correspondence I can write like this, and a2 plus b2. So I have to just collect the coefficients. So basically this is nothing but the addition of these two column vectors in R2. So, and again you can transfer back to the R2, to the G. So I can write like this: a1 cos theta plus a2 sin theta plus f b1 cos theta plus b2 sin theta. So in this way we have proved that the property of addition is preserved during this kind of mapping. Now I am going to do next computation. So the next computation shows that f preserves a scalar multiplications is similar. So I will apply a scalar multiplication in the first space, a1 cos theta and a2 sin theta, and after that you can see that I can also write like this: a1 cos theta plus r a2 sin theta. So basically from the correspondence I can write like this, and this is nothing but a scaling in the second space. So now you can convert the second space to first space, and a1 cos theta plus b1 or a2. So just remove this, basically I have a2, so I have a2 sin theta. So in this way we have proved that property 1 and 2 both are verified. So due to this reason I can write that two spaces. So basically I have a space G is isomorphic, so I am going to use this symbol, to the R2. So both are isomorphic. And whatever function f I have defined, that is a isomorphism. So this is an isomorphism. So in this way, we are defining the two spaces, isomorphism between two spaces with respect to some correspondence. And space G and R2 is exactly the same if we will consider this kind of mapping. So one cannot distinguish between space 1 and space 2. So similarly, another example. So here this example is some little more special, because using this example it is possible to show that one space may be isomorphic to the several spaces at the same time. So let V be the space, and suppose the form of a space is like this, that I have C1x plus C2y plus C3z, where C1, C2 and C3 belongs to R of linear combinations of three variables under the natural addition and scalar multiplication, means classical addition and scalar multiplication I am going to talk, and scalar multiplication operations. So whenever we are writing mathematical sentences, at that time we have to specify each and everything. Then I am going to tell that V is isomorphic to P2, and P2 is the space of the quadratic polynomial, the space of quadratic polynomials, and in order to prove this. So I'm going to change the color. So here basically I have two. So this we must produce an isomorphic or isomorphism map and if we see the isomorphism map there is more than one possibility involved here because we are talking about the space of linear combination to the polynomial. So there is more than one possibility and out of that possibility suppose that I have four choices. Here are four, two choose among. So suppose that I have defined the first map. So first map is like this. So I have first space that is C1x. After that I have plus C2y plus C3z and I have different kind of mapping. So first mapping F1 to some kind of quadratic polynomial, a space of quadratic polynomial. Why I am telling a space? Because I can choose C1, C2 and C3 to any real number. So I have something like this. Another one is F2, that is something like this. Another one may be something like this. And fourth one may be like this. Similarly, I can define more one. And in order to show that both space is isomorphic, again I have to first prove that whatever map I have taken that satisfy the property of 1-1 and on 2. And after that, I have to talk about the preservance of the structure. So it is very easy to show. Just you can first show that this function satisfy the property of 1-1 and on 2, and after that you can just verify the addition and multiplication. So I am not going to write the full solution of this because I think this is very much straightforward. But in this way, you are able to understand that I have different kind of quadratic function and they map from one particular space to that particular quadratic polynomial. Both are again form the same space with respect to some particular mapping, that is F1, F2, F3 and F4, if they satisfy the two property, first property related to the correspondence and second property related to the preservation of structure, then one can tell that the space formed by the linear combination of three variables under the natural addition and multiplication, and second space formed by the quadratic polynomial, both are isomorphic. And I can again give the another example, and that example is actually obvious. So example is like this. Every space is isomorphic to itself. Under the identity map. Identity map means we are mapping from the same quantity to that quantity, and this is very easy to check, so I am not going to again prove this. Now I am going to talk about the next definition. So till now what we have observed, that I have two different kind of space. One space may be column space, another space may be some kind of function space. And under what condition these two space one can define, or one can tell that these two space are same? How to check that? So if we believe on the definition of isomorphism, then I can tell that these two space means column space, some kind of matrix space, some kind of function space are the same. And whenever we are talking about sameness, then we are talking about the preservation of some property, preservation of some structure. Now I am going to find the next definition, and that definition actually tells about the sameness of the some space with itself. Suppose that I have some space in R2, and after that, after some kind of operation, if I again in R2, then under what condition we can tell that those two space are same? So it is possible to show that that is automatically satisfy the second property. So I have to just somehow to check the first property, means we have to define the function or correspondence in such a way such that it will satisfy the property of 1-1 and 1-2. So let us write the second definition. So second definition is the definition of, that is called automorphism. So and automorphism is an isomorphism of a space with itself. And we know what is meaning of isomorphism. So again, we have to check these two properties. So let us see the automorphism using some examples. So I'm going to write about first example. So a dilation map, and I am going to define dilation map by ds. So again, if I am diluting something, then we are basically remains on the same space. So I have considered the R2 space, and after dilation I am again in R2 space. So basically we are on the same space that multiplies all vectors by a non-zero scalars S is and auto morphism of R2, and this is very obvious to check that both operation and correspondence both are satisfied. So basically we are talking like this, that suppose that I have R2 space, and again after operation I am going to live on the same space where I am going to define operation like this. So dilation, and suppose that 1.5 means I am going to dilute by, if my length is 1, then that is going to extend by 1.5. so basically I have suppose two vectors I will take. Basically this kind of operation I have to do for each and every vector in this space. So I am not going to show about each and every vector, I am just going to show this kind of things for the two vectors. So basically we are telling that any vector, if you take in this space and in this space, so this is 1.5 V and this is D 1.5. so D 1.5 and this is, so that is the meaning. So again this is the automorphism. Now I am going to write the second example. So another example, another automorphism is a rotation or turning map, and t theta, again I am going to consider the same space that rotates all vectors and angle theta. So basically I am going to talk about this, that I have R2 space and I have applied the map. So I am going to talk about the turning by angle pi by 6. So each vector in this space is going to turn by this particular angle. So basically if I have some vector u like this, so after that in this space if you see any vector, so that will looks like this. Similarly, I have third type of automorphism. So a third type of automorphism of R2 is a map F and I am going to define this map by FL that flips or reflects all vectors over a line through origin. So again, that will satisfy the property of isomorphism, and since this will map from same space to same space due to that region, I will tell this as a automorphism. So again, I have some mapping and I have reflection about this particular line. So now you can consider the vectors. So suppose I have some vector like this. So I am going to talk about this FL U, and here mapping is like this. So these are the three very common example of the automorphism. So till now what we have seen, that I have two space. So how to talk about the sameness of that space? So in first part of this lecture, I was talking about the isomorphism, and after that we are talking about the automorphism where both space are the exactly same. So now we are going to see the next definition, and that definition is little bit less strict than the definition of isomorphism, and somehow during the definition of isomorphism we are talking about the sameness of the space. Now we are not going to talk about the sameness of the two space. Now we are just going to tell that how two space are alike. So now I am going to talk about the alikeness of space. So let us come to the next discussion, and next part of discussion is focus on the homomorphism. And I have already told you that in this homomorphism part, I am going to talk about the electness of the space. So I'm going to talk how spaces are alike. So if you recall the first one, that is isomorphism. So basically isomorphism has two different property, and first property preserve the structure. And if you see the second property, that is required for the correspondence. And if these two property are satisfied, then we are telling that whatever space, so we are going to talk about following thing, that describe how spaces are the same. So either you can tell that spaces are the same, or you can check these two property. So we are telling that both are exactly the same, and name for that particular correspondence plus structure is called isomorphism. In this part of course, I am going to drop the second one, that is correspondence, and I am just going to talk about the two different space which just preserve the structure. So we are not hoping that the two space will also preserve the correspondence. Correspondence means we are going to talk about one to one and on to, but we are just interested in the preservation of the structure. And if two different space are preserve the structure, then we can coin a new terminology or new definition, and that is called homomorphism. So let us just define the homomorphism. So next definition is related to the homomorphism, or commonly people are also telling this as a linear map, and we are going to use this concept to define several new things in the incoming part of our lecture. And actually the concept of homomorphism has several applications in field of the system theory or control theory. So let us define the homomorphism. So a function between vector spaces, and suppose that function H is for homomorphism V to W that deserves addition. So if V1, V2 belongs to V, then if I apply this function, then I will write like this. Plus HV2 and a scalar multiplication so if V belongs to this space and I have some scalar R, then I can write like this is a homomorphism or linear map. And let us try to see the example. So I have just dropped the first condition, that is condition of 1 1 and 1 2. So I have allowed some kind of flexibility here, but now I will not tell that two space are the same. Now I am just hoping that two space are alike in terms of the preservance of the operation. So let us see the examples. So first example, the projection map pi from R3 to R2. So I am going to project something from 3-dimensional space to 2-dimensional space. So these are the points in 3-dimensional space, and after that I am going to apply this kind of map in 2-dimensional space, and we are going to show that this mapping is a satisfy the property of homomorphism. So in order to show this, I have to check two property of addition and scalar multiplication. So preserves addition. So suppose I have this kind of, and after that I will take one element, and so x1 y1 z1 from the R3, and again x2 y2 and z2 from the same space, and after that I will apply this map pi. So I can also write like this: x1 x2 y1 y2 and z1 z2. And if you see the codomain part, at that time I have x1 plus x2 and y1 plus y2, and I can again return back to the original. X2, Y2, Z2. So in this way, we have proved that it is able to preserve the addition. Now I am going to show that second one will also preserve, that is about the scalar multiplication. So I have selected the sum element, that is x1, y1, z1, and after that a scalar r, and after that I will apply the mapping pi. So I can write like this: pi x1, pi y1, or pi z1. So in the codomain I can do like this, and again I can transfer back like this. y1 z1, like this. So in this way I can show that the projection from three-dimensional space to two-dimensional space, that is R3 to R2, satisfy the property of homomorphism. Now let us check that, is it possible to show that this will also satisfy the property of isomorphism, because again these are the map between two space, and it is possible to show that this will not satisfy the property of the isomorphism. So this is not an isomorphism. And why? Because it is not one-to-one, and we have to show that why I am telling that this is not one-to-one. So in order to show this, just you can do by counter example. So you can create some kind of counter example where one-to-one will not satisfy. So you can take two vectors in this space, that is 0 vector and 1 vector is 0, 0, 1. So I have selected two vectors. So first vector is, so for instance, both this vector and, so both are in R3, map to the 0 vector in R2. Due to that reason we are telling that this will not satisfy the property of 1-to-1. So I cannot talk about the correspondence between two space, means R3 and R2. So that will just satisfy the property of homomorphism, and that is not the isomorphism. So whenever we are projecting anything from the three-dimensional space to two-dimensional, then that will not satisfy the property of isomorphism. Now let us see some more examples. So next I'm going to talk about the example. The domain and codomain can be other than the spaces of column vectors . So in first example, what we have seen, that our domain and codomain both are as a column vector. Now next example, I am going to see that even if that is not a column vector, then also that will satisfy the property of homomorphism. So I am going to take the two examples that is different from the column vectors but still isomorphic, in order to visualize that this concept is not just restricted to the column space only. So the verification are straightforward. So whatever things I am going to write, there is no need to verify, because that is obvious. So let us try to see the first one. So suppose that some function f1 which will map from polynomial p2 to some polynomial p3 given by the following. So I have quadratic polynomial, so this is the space of the quadratic polynomial, and I am going to create one map that is the space of the polynomial of order 3 into x square plus a2 by 3 x cube. Again, these two are homomorphic to each other. So now I am going to show another example from the matrix space. So suppose this is mapping from 2 cross 2 matrix to R. So suppose that I have any generalized matrix, and if I define this kind of map A plus D. So in order to make clarity, and it is possible to show again that then these two are again homomorphic, means spaces M2 cross 2 space, and this is one dimensional space under this mapping. So always mapping is one of the most important element whenever we are defining the isomorphism or homomorphism. So another example, again I am going to coin. So that example is about the zero homomorphism. So between any two spaces there is a zero homomorphism. That will map in every vector in the domain to the zero vector in the codomain. Now one more example I am going to give, and basically this example tells us that why we are also telling homomorphism as a linear map. So example, second example, this is the third one. So these two suggest why we use the term linear map. So let us consider the first map, the map G, that will map from three dimensional space to one dimensional, given by the following way I have defined the map. So I have x, y, z. So this is in three dimensional space. Now I will apply some kind of map G such that I will get, suppose this. Is linear, that is a homomorphism. So somehow I am mapping from three dimensional space to one dimensional space, and you can see here that if I do this kind of mapping, then this will satisfy the property of the homomorphism. And somehow this function, we already know that this is a linear function. So due to that reason, in another way, people are also telling that this map is a linear map. So let us see another map which is not linear. So x, y, z, again you can take same map, and now you can apply another operation, and just you can see here that is plus 1. And it is possible to show that this will not preserve the property of homomorphism. So basically, and this is very easy to show. So I'm not going to show it. So not a linear map. So if you add plus 1 to this particular function, then that will not satisfy the property of the linear map. So addition operation basically will not preserve here. Now let us try to see the another example. So suppose I have some map T1 and T2 that will map from R3 to R2. So 3-dimensional space to 2-dimensional space, and again I have some kind of linear combination. So this map will give some kind of linear combination of two element like this. And suppose that another map I have, this is T2, and again that is like this. So you can see here that I have three element in R3 space, and finally I am defining the another space that is the some kind of linear combination of these element, and it will satisfy the property of the homomorphism. So this is homomorphism. So I have to change this. So I am going to write homomorphism, or you can also tell this as a linear map. And it is possible to show that due to this term, this is not a linear map. So in this way I can generate lot of example, different kind of example, that two different space may preserve the structure. If they preserve the structure, then we can tell that two space is homomorphic to one another. Some space may preserve a structure apart from the correspondence, then we are telling that is also isomorphic to each other. Now I have another kind of definition, and basically our next class is based on that particular definition, that is called linear transformation. And using the idea of linear transformation, we can generalize the lot of theory related to linear systems. So due to that reason, first we try to see that what is meaning of the sameness of a space, what is meaning of two space is alike. Now we are going to see some kind of linear map which map from A space to itself, and that is called linear transformation. So, and that particular linear transformation is the topic of our next class. So just you can write the definition, and after that I will close the class and I will discuss the more about the linear transformation in next class. So definition of linear transformation, and basically using this linear transformation we will again define the difference between linear and nonlinear systems. So a linear map, linear map means homomorphism from a space into itself, that is called T V to V is a linear transformation. And we are going to see the property of, or several example of this linear transformation in the next class. So what is main conclusion of today's class? That using the idea of isomorphism or homomorphism, one can define that two spaces are either same or just alike. So that is the main idea of the today class, and this idea is very 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 much applicable in the several part of the engineering problems. So I hope that you have understood the concept. With this remark, I am going to close the today class. Thank you very much.